Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you a whole bunch of tips for using multiple desktops, spaces, and mission control on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So one of the most useful features in macOS is the ability to have multiple spaces or desktops or full screen apps on your Mac. It makes it feel like you have multiple screens when you only have one. So let's activate Mission Control using Control and Up Arrow, the keyboard shortcut. And here you can see I've got two desktops and three full screen apps. These are all called spaces. So I have five spaces. And a space can contain a desktop with multiple windows in it or a full screen app. A space can also contain two apps. That's called split view. Now the basics of using Mission Control are to use that keyboard shortcut to see these spaces here at the top. You can use the plus button here on the right to create new desktops. And then you could drag and drop windows from one desktop to the other. If you want to turn a regular window into a full screen app, you can click the green button here. And then it's a full screen app. And now you can see I've got four full screen apps. You can get rid of the full screen app like that and it jumps back to its desktop. But there are a ton of other ways to do this. There are so many gestures, keyboard shortcuts, and combinations that you can use. So here are some tips and tricks. First, to activate Mission Control, you can use that Control Up Arrow keyboard shortcut. But you can also get to it a variety of other ways. If you go into System Preferences and then look under Trackpad if you're using a trackpad or Mouse if you're using a mouse, there are some gestures. Here for Trackpad, under More Gestures, you could see here that I could go into Mission Control with swipe up with four fingers. I could also make that three fingers. So four fingers swiped up on the trackpad and it takes me into Mission Control. Now if you go into the Mission Control settings, this is where you can change the keyboard shortcut if you like. But you can also go to Hot Corners and set a hot corner for Mission Control. So for instance, I can make the upper left hand corner go to Mission Control. And now I can just move my pointer up there to go to Mission Control. But in addition to that, you can also add a modifier key. So instead of just Mission Control, I can hold Command down and you can see it's Command Mission Control. So now going to the top left corner won't do anything. But if I hold the Command key down and go to the top left corner, it will go to Mission Control. Now while we're here, there are a couple of other settings I want to point out. One is group windows by application. So let's say I have multiple windows open for an app. For instance, here I've got a Finder window. Let me open up two more Finder windows here. Now, if I have group windows by application turned off and I go into Mission Control, see how those three Finder windows are separate from each other. But if I turn it on and I go into Mission Control, see how it groups them all together. I can still select which one I want to jump to and it will bring that one to the front, but they take up less space in Mission Control. Also, if you have multiple screens attached to your Mac, then you can choose whether to have displays have separate spaces. So, if I had my pointer here in this display, I could activate Mission Control and it would just be for this screen. The other screen would remain as it was. But if I turn this off, then going into Mission Control takes both screens into Mission Control and they're kind of linked together. Try each one of those settings to fully understand how it works. Also, I'd like to have automatically rearranged spaces based on most recent use turned off. If it's turned on, then the order that these are in will change all the time. I like to have a mental map in my head of where things are. Now when you're using Mission Control, you can do a lot with drag and drop. For instance, if you want to arrange these spaces, you can move them around like that. Just drag and drop any one of them to change the order. But you could also drag and drop the windows below. So here I'm in Desktop 1 and it has Reminders and Notes. I can drag Reminders to Desktop 2 and move it there. I can switch to this next desktop. Now if I click here, it's going to go to it. But if I use the keyboard shortcuts, Control Left and Control Right arrow, it will do it but keeping Mission Control at the top. So I could go here and drag this to this space instead. Now you could also use these for full screen apps. So if I want to make Reminders a full screen app, instead of dragging it to Desktop 2, I can drag it over here and create a full screen version of it anywhere I want. So instead of having to click the green button here, enter full screen, or do view, enter full screen, I could simply remember the way to get into Mission Control, and then drag this up and create a full screen window that way. And you can also use the same thing for creating split view. So I could drag it here and you can see how it will put reminders either the left or right side of Safari or the left or right side of Photos. Same thing for Mail. And I can easily create split view that way. In fact, I could create reminders and notes split view by dragging this one here, creating a new space, dragging the next one there, and now this is split view. You can also combine full screen apps into split view by dragging and then placing it here. So you can see I can combine Safari and Mail like that. It's not working here on Photos because there's simply not enough space to share a split view with Safari and Photos. Remember, split view depends on the app. The app has to support it and there has to be enough space to have that window in a split view. Now you can also drag without actually going into Mission Control. This only works if you have one screen. It doesn't seem to work if you've got multiple screens. But if I take Reminders here, and remember I've got the second desktop right to the right of desktop one. If I take this window, drag it over to the edge, and wait, it will shift over to the other desktop and I could drop it there. And I could take it back to that first desktop by dragging to the left and waiting. You could also drag up to the top. Move your mouse all the way to the top and then try to push beyond it. And then it goes into Mission Control and I could add it to this desktop here. You have to go to the top and then kind of push a second time to get that to work. Now this also works for files. Let me go over to the Mail app right here and let's say I'm composing a message and I want to attach a file to this. I could go back to the desktop here that has a file on it. And if I grab the file and drive over to the right, it's going to go to the next space, and then the next space, until I'm here, and then I could drop it into this document, in this case an email message. Now you can also use the keyboard shortcuts or gestures to do this. So if I click and drag this file here, and I'm holding down the trackpad with just my thumb, and I take four fingers and swipe with the trackpad, still while holding my thumb down the entire time, then I could go over and drop it there. Or I could use the keyboard shortcut. So I'm dragging this, I can do control right arrow a bunch of times until I get to where I want and drop it. Now let's say I want to look at two Safari pages side by side in split view, but I'm here in a full screen Safari. I can actually make this split view by creating two tabs. I have one tab here. Let's create a second tab, just Command T, and I'll go to another page. And let's say I want to see both of those at the same time. You could drag a tab in Safari like this, drag it to the top, and push past the top a second time. And now I can put that as a full screen space here. I could drag it onto a desktop, or I can use the original window here and make it go split view. So now, back in here, I've created a split view that used to be two separate tabs. Now it's two separate browser windows in split view. And when I want to close one of these, I can just simply click the red button just like you would normally. It closes that window and the other half of the screen becomes the full screen window. Now Mail also has some special features when it comes to full screen apps. There are two modes. One mode is when you go to view a message, say by double clicking it, it opens up this special window on top and everything kind of gets dimmed behind it. The same thing happens when you go to compose a new message. Now whenever you're doing this, say composing a new message, if you click outside of it, the message appears down at the bottom here and you can get it back by clicking there. As a matter of fact, if you compose multiple new messages, then you'll see two tabs here. And you can see the two tabs here at the bottom. But there's another way to do it. If you go to Mail Preferences and then you go to General, look for Prefer Opening Messages in Split View when in full screen. Turn that on. Now when you compose a new message, it becomes split view with one half of the screen being your regular mail window and the other being the message composition window. Now in full screen mode you get the menu bar here at the top, but it's gone normally. When you bring your pointer to the top, that's when it will appear. But if you go into System Preferences, and this is new in macOS Monterey, go to Dock and Menu Bar, then Dock and Menu Bar here, you can turn off automatically hide and show the menu bar in full screen mode. But you do have to quit the app and then launch it again for it to take effect. But you see now I get the menu bar all the time. Very handy, especially when you like to check the date and time and other things like, say, Wi-Fi status and such in the menu bar. It's difficult when you can't see them and you have to stop what you're doing and move the pointer up to the top. So when you want to go into split view, one way to do it is to hover over the green button here in the window, tile window to the left side of the screen, and then you'll be given other windows that could be on the other side of the screen. So in this case, let's pick notes. Now we're in split view. Now previous to Monterey, if you wanted to change one of the halves of the split view, you would have to basically exit split view, but now you can do it without actually going anywhere. If I move my cursor over the green button here, now I can select replace tiled window. Click that, and now it's going to show me another option. So in this case, the only other option is Finder. And I can click there. You can see how quickly I swapped out notes for the Finder. And I could do the same thing over here, for instance. I could replace this half here with notes. So you can keep switching halves in split view rather than having to exit split view and recreate it. Now there's also a special command if you go to the dock and you control click on any app. So for instance, let's pick the Reminders app. I can control click that and then I could go to Options and there's Assign to All Desktops, This Desktop, or None. None is the normal state. But if you want to assign it specifically to this desktop, you can. Now, if you go into Reminders, Quit Reminders, and say you're at another desktop, when you launch Reminders, it will launch it in the desktop it's assigned to, not the one that you're currently at, and it will jump to it. Now you also have the ability to select all desktops. This will show the window on all of the desktop spaces. So I'll do that for Calculator here. That's a handy app to do it for. If I launch Calculator here on desktop 1 and say I'm doing a calculation, I can go to desktop 2 and notice the calculator is still there. So it's in both places. The same window, but on all of the desktops. Desktop 1 and desktop 2 in this case. And here's one last tip I want to show you. You can have different desktop backgrounds for different desktops. So right now I've got these two desktops here, and if they have a lot of windows on it, sometimes it can be confusing as to which one you're on. But you can go to a desktop. Let's go to the second one here. And if I go to System Preferences and then Desktop and Screensaver, Desktop, and change the desktop, let's switch to this one. See how it changes there? But if I go back to this desktop, notice how it's still the same as it was before. I have two different desktop backgrounds. And if I look in Mission Control, I'll even see that here. That makes it a little bit easier to tell where you're at if you have a lot of desktops. Now here's an untip, something you can't do, but it gets asked all the time, so I thought I'd address it. You can't name a desktop. Obviously full screen apps and split view apps get named after the app, but desktop 1, desktop 2, those are just numbers. You've never been able to name desktops. The idea is they're just numbered, and they're numbered in the order that they appear. So as I switch them, you can see how they change their number. So there are a whole bunch of different tips for using spaces or Mission Control on your Mac. I hope that maybe this gets you to try out spaces if you haven't been using them. And if you have been using them, I hope I showed you some new tricks that you could use. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.